In our video introducing FileMaker's support for Core ML, I mentioned that it is up to FileMaker developers to find out attributes of the machine learning model they want to use to understand how to use them. You can do this by reading the documentation of the model or opening it using Xcode. Both are inconvenient. Welcome back to the channel. This is Wei Hao at Direct Impact Solutions. Today, I'm going to show you how I used a new feature from FileMaker 19.3.1 to build Core ML models repository that automatically extract model information. We will go over some quirky behavior of dragging and dropping a file into a container field and how we overcome it, and introduce a technique called virtualist. Let's start by introducing this new feature. In version 19.3.1, FileMaker introduced a new function called GetModelAttributes that can read a model's attributes directly from a loaded Core ML model. So, if you have a model already loaded using the configure machine learning model script step, call the GetModelAttributes function with the model's name, will give you the model's attributes in JSON. This is quite straightforward. If some of you have seen my previous video on Core ML, linked in the description, I had a model table that I used to store different Core ML model files. For all these fields here, I need to populate them manually. I want to drag and drop a model into the container field and have the rest of this information automatically populated. So, I created a script that will load the model, get the model attributes, save it to a field, and unload the model to wrap things up. The script itself works great, so I thought, well, this is going to be easy. I was wrong. My roadblock was the quirky behavior of dragging and dropping a file into a container field. At first, I tried to use the onObjectSave script trigger to fire the script I wrote. Then I noticed that it doesn't always fire when I drag and drop the file into the container. It turned out that the onObjectSave script trigger will only fire if the container field is active when you do the drag and drop. Otherwise, FileMaker is going to commit the record directly and bypass the onObjectSave trigger. So then I thought maybe I can use the onRecordCommit script trigger to achieve what I want. And to my surprise, the onRecordCommit trigger also gets bypassed even though the record did commit. I did some tests and confirmed if the container field is the only field modified and this modification is done by drag and drop, it will bypass the onRecordCommit trigger. However, if other fields are also modified before the container data is committed, then the onRecordCommit trigger will fire. This is such bizarre behavior from FileMaker. At this point, I thought of two ways to make this work. Please don't laugh at me because my first approach was overly complicated as I turned to the base elements plugin's BE script execute function to call a script directly from the data layer like this. This autoenter will fire when the model field gets modified on any layout. And it worked. But then I thought, since this autoenter fires when I modify the model field, why don't I try the onObjectModify script trigger and see how that goes? It turned out that also works, even with drag and drop. I did not think about using the onObjectModify trigger because normally when I want to have a script trigger that does something after updating a field, I would use the onObjectSave trigger, as it only gets fired when I'm done with data entry. If I use onObjectModify, every time I type a character, the trigger will fire. But in this case, since I'm dealing with a container field, there's only one editing action, which is caused by the drag and drop. Plus, the quirky behavior we mentioned earlier with onObjectSave and onRecordCommit makes onObjectModify a good option here. And compared to my first approach with the plugin, I don't have to rely on a plugin using the onObjectModify trigger. So this is what I ended up doing. After successfully building a workflow that will get the model attributes, I started parsing the JSON data and display them. Here, you can see the raw model attributes JSON. Most information we need is in the model description object. For information like description, author, and license, they're all in the metadata object. I used autointers with the JSON getElement function to parse them out. But for developers, the most important attributes would be input and output, as those define how we use the model. For input and output, they reside in the input description and output description objects, respectively. To display them, I used a technique called the virtual list. The idea is to have a table made with placeholder records and fields that will parse out data stored in a global variable or a global field to display data without creating actual records for each one of them. Take the input as an example. I have this table referencing a global variable named model input and parse out its value using calculation fields. I then use an onRecordLoad script trigger to update the value of the model input global variable. So when I go to a different model record, the value refreshes. I did the same thing for output. So now I have my repository for my CoreML model files that automatically show me this model's attributes when I insert them. This makes managing models much easier. I wish Claris will enhance the getContainerAttributes function to do something similar to this, but with plugin files inserted into container fields. The demo file is available for download, linked in the description. That's the end of the video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We publish FileMaker videos every week. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.